Hey, what's up everybody? My name is Zach King, and in this lesson for Motion 5, I'm going to be showing you how to create a flourish. This is an example of a flourish right here. This is the finished product that we're going to be creating today. This is a simple flourish. There's a lot more complex flourishes out there, like these ones. And now my example, like I said, is very simple. There's three strokes in this flourish. They don't even cross paths, and that's great for starting. And once you understand the concept that I'm going through today, you'll understand how to do the more difficult ones. It's just a lot more time consuming. I don't think you want to sit here watching me create the flourishes for an hour and I'm sitting here recording this tutorial for an hour. So it's a win-win to go over a simple flourish. Let's get started. So we're making our way down to this toolbar where we've got the Bezier. I don't know if I'm ever saying that right. Bezier. I say it both ways. Either way, click this and zoom in here to your project. And we're just going to create a path. Notice I'm going to start outside. Just so the animation can start. You'll see later why I did that. But go ahead and just come around the path. Try to stay on as much as you can. If you hold and drag these handles, it allows you to have some control over the curve, the smoothness there. And so as many points as you need, just, again, cover and then go off. I go off a little bit at the end just for safety. So this is what we've got, but you can't see anything right now. So go ahead and make sure we put this Bezier into a new group. So let's right click, new group up here, and I'm going to call these shapes. And there's going to be three shapes since we have three lines. So let's drag this Bezier in there. You'll see that there. But first, let me explain the organization of the project. You see on top I've got shapes. I made a group for the flourish, and by the way, this is in the download you can get in my project file. It's completely free. Just click the link. Just go to FinalCutKing.com. You'll be able to download this for free. So the flourish file here is what I dragged into the project. I set it up with a white background rectangle. Really simple. That's in its own background group, and then the flourish, and then the shape. So shapes do need to be separate. If we open up our heads-up display, you can open up right here if you don't have it, the HUD. Open up the HUD and click the Bezier shape. We've got these preferences. Let's uncheck the fill. We don't want that. We want the outline. Now the outline color doesn't matter at all. In fact, I would not make it white. Go ahead and make it orange or something, a cool color. Or you can go with my favorite color, which is blue. There we go. So the width, you need to open this up and it needs to cover any black. So as long as it's covered, you're good to go. Let's make the other two shapes real quick. Make sure we're in the shapes section, and we're just going to come over here like that. Okay, so I'm gonna go ahead and be organized. We're gonna call this the top. I'm gonna call this one the middle, and we can keep them separate colors, that's fine. You do need to come in and adjust every time. Uncheck the fill, go ahead and make the width a little bit bigger, and I'm gonna go ahead and create one more. Let's do the bottom one. There we are, and I will adjust the color. I'm gonna make it a different color since we're in the mood of creating different colors. And the outline, nice and big for itself. Now this kind of looks weird, but let me show you the principle of what we're doing. We are gonna take the flourish group, right click, and go to Add Image Mask, Shift Command M. So once you got that, you've got this little well in your heads-up display, or it's also in your inspector here. You just need to drop and drag these shapes on top into that image well, and they disappear. Now you're like, what the heck, that doesn't make sense. First of all, let's go to the middle, and we'll animate this one by coming here to last point offset, and notice that it has the animation. So here's how we do the animation. Let's record. My playhead's in the beginning. I'm gonna jump 90 frames in or so. And I'm going to have the last point offset right here. And we'll take a look at the animation. We adjust them by hitting Command 8. That opens up the keyframe editor. Here in the bottom, you'll see this pink line. And this is, again, the last point offset animation. So just right click, interpolation, and go to continuous. Instead of linear, we have a nice curved line here. And that'll ease it in and out as it starts its animation. If you want to make it shorter or longer, we would drag this to the right. It'll take more time. Shorter, we would drag this to the left. But how I had it is pretty spot on, I must say. So now to animate the other two, let's go ahead and do that. We've got the top here. Let's go ahead and bring this to the beginning. We'll pull this one off. We can animate both at once. We'll go to the bottom. I'll drag that off too. So I'll hit record. We'll go 90 frames in. Bring the last point offset to 100 for the bottom. Make sure we're animating both at the same time. So I'm going to go to the top too. If I play these, you'll see they animate nice and neat. They end at the same time, but they're not smooth, the bottom and top. So right click, interpolation continuous. Same with the top. We need to make this continuous. So how about we time them up a little bit different? If I play this, you'll see they all start at the same time. Actually, a lot of flourishes will start here in the beginning, and once they kind of would have hit, so this top one wouldn't start yet. I'm just going to move it over a little behind. The bottom, I'm going to delay it a lot more behind, so you'll see that one starts there, like that. Let's play. If you're having problems where the top one, notice the top one kind of just starts in and jumps. The reason is because I didn't give it that space in the beginning. So we need to actually adjust the points. What you'll do is turn this back on so you can edit it, double click, and I'm just going to pull this back a little bit. It's okay if they overlap. That's fine. Let's turn it off. And now you'll see it actually animates on. That makes sense right there instead of starting right on the point. So that's why I said give yourself a little space off the side. Remember how I did that here at the blue. We can even adjust the green by double clicking, moving it off to the side. And there is how you animate a flourish. Like I said, it's super easy. And now you can get in more complex flourishes. And you know how you can get the flourishes, by the way, is if you just Google flourishes, go to images. If they're royalty free, a lot of people post these for free on their websites, you can find good ones. You save them to your computer and drag them into your projects and animate those by doing this process. I had a handwriting effect for Motion 5 tutorial a couple months back, and this is just the same process. But in that tutorial, I remember I used the paintbrush tool to do that. So this is just another technique. If you want to see that handwriting tutorial, you can click right here. Or if you're new to Motion 5, I highly recommend you watch this tutorial right over here, which will get you into the basics. And also, if you just want all the lists of my tutorials on my site, go to FinalCutKing.com, and you'll see I've got quite a few free tutorials on there. I've also got some training courses if you want like more in-depth stuff. You can stream that online. You can download that. Anyway, I hope whatever project you're working on right now, you finish it well. It turns out great, and I hope your life flourishes. See what I did there? Okay, I'm done. Anyway, I'm Zach King. If you want to connect with me, go to facebook.com/thefinalcutking. Say hi to me there. Tell me what you want to see in another tutorial, and I'd love to talk with you. Anyway, peace out, guys.